What's up, everybody? Welcome back. Thank you so much for taking the time to hang out. EMT here, and in this video, we are taking out for a spin the brand new FeiyuTech Vimble 3 smartphone gimbal, and we're going to put it to the test. We're going to compare it against a stabilization of the DJI Omen 5 and a couple of extra things and reasons why I think this gimbal might be worth your while. Let's dive in. FeiyuTech Vimble 3 will set you back $119. However, I have seen it a little bit less than that. I've seen it for $109 at times. So make sure you check the link in the description if you're looking to save some money. The FeiyuTech Vimble 3 supports 260 grams of payload capacity, which means that your smartphones, your big smartphones like the 13 Pro Max or the Pixel 6 Pro, will fit no problem. Those are around the 240 grams, but this means you have a little bit of extra headroom for any smartphone cases, as well as filters, lenses, and things like that. The Vimble 3 includes a pouch, a tripod, and of course, a charger. Almost forgot to mention that the FeiyuTech Vimble 3 has 10 hours of battery life. That could last you an entire Disney World or Disneyland day. I know it has lasted that long for me, so. I want to jump straight to reason number one, which is the image stabilization, right? We get gimbals because we want to minimize the shaky videos that we capture on our trips, vacations, things like that. Now, I had the opportunity to take the Vimble 3 to New York City and compare it against the stabilization of the DJI Omen 5, as well as good old handheld video. I gotta say, the image stabilization situation is actually pretty on point. At this point, image stabilization in the industry when you're using these gimbals is very similar. And even digital image stabilization from just good old handheld is getting really good. You can definitely tell when you zoom in, when we do that 300% crop, you can see that now the image stabilization when you're good old handheld and smartphones is more of a floaty image stabilization versus a little bit more hermetic, a little bit more robotic image stabilization. There is still a little bit of bounce if you're just walking normal, but if you bend your knees and do that good old ninja walking, you're gonna get butter. Butter B-roll, butter smooth video. Now, reason number two is gonna be the foldable design. And it's one of those things where I saw the gimbal for the very first time and I was like, this actually reminds me a lot of other gimbals. Yes, this gimbal looks very similar to the DJI Omen 3 and of course the DJI Omen 4, but I actually like that it's very similar to the Omen 3. It's a little bit more traditional looking gimbal, which removes a lot of the extracurricular accessory attaching and removing that the Omen 4 and the 5 brought to the table. And don't get me wrong, those are two phenomenal gimbals, but at $119, sometimes at $109, a little bit more traditional approach is often needed for individuals that might not really be into filmmaking, photography, videography. They just want easy, insert the smartphone and go. And this gimbal is a interestingly refreshing callback to the way smartphone gimbals used to be a couple of years ago. Not a lot of parts, just the gimbal, the tripod, and that's it. Reason number three is the extension rod. The Vimble 3 has a 198mm extension rod that allows you to get a little bit more separation if you're vlogging. And this could be the difference between just your face being in the frame or maybe the environment, maybe a couple of friends getting a little bit of that separation. You can get a lot more information there. Not to mention, if you're live streaming or if you're recording like I am, being able to extend it to eye level is very, very clutch. This also makes it a lot easier to go underslung when you're recording footsteps or things lower to the ground, as well as cinematic shots like crane shot or maybe a slider shot that's underslung, right? So this gives you the ability not only to get that extra elevation or distance, but also it's very versatile for those cinematic approaches. Branches of a tree, and you can reach and do a reveal shot by being able to extend, or maybe you're recording a skateboarder and you can go low to the ground without bending too much and messing up your back like I have in the past. The extension capability is here to stay, and I'm a fan of gimbals that have that capability. Long are the days that we're using selfie sticks and sticks alone. This gives you the best of both worlds. Stabilization with extension, love it. Next up are the A and B buttons on the left side of the gimbal. The FeiyuTech Vimble 3 has A and B buttons on the left side of the gimbal, and that gives you the ability to do focus racking on the fly without actually interacting with the phone. You just simply tap on your first focus point that you can set, and then B, you can switch it on the fly to an additional focus point. So if you're recording someone that is in front of the camera, but then that person turns away and you want to record the foreground, you can preset those two focal points and just with the tap of a button switch back and forth. You can also have the ability to use these buttons for zoom. Let's say you're recording a video of the kids at a football game, and from where you're sitting, you have the wide angle shot because you want to capture the entire field. But you know that you want to zoom in to that end zone. You can preset those two zoom points. Zoom A would be the ultra wide one, and then B will be the zoom. And then whenever the ball is moving that way, you can just press the button and it zooms in automatically. You don't have to interact with the screen or do anything like that, which is awesome. This also helps creating those automatic dolly zoom shots where you can move backwards as you're zooming in or move forward as you're zooming out to create that background compression Hitchcock-like effect. Let's not forget about the dial. Right in front of the gimbal, you have a dial that allows you to change your focus and pretty much just manually go back and forth. That's how I set my point A to point B, by just simply moving that dial left or right. But it's cool to be able to do that on the fly without interacting with the screen. You can still use the slider on the left to zoom in or zoom out, but it's so cool that you have these three different tools that allow you to tackle three different parts of the journey, which is your focus and of course the zooming in and out, as well as presets your point A to point B. In the back of the gimbal, you'll also find a trigger that does what the trigger does. If you hold it down, it pretty much locks everything in place. And if you double click it, it returns back to normal. But there's a secondary trigger, and it's a customizable trigger. And if you're considering picking up the FeiyuTech Vimble 3, I highly encourage you to play with these settings, because it could be the difference between this gimbal being right on the spot for you or just being another gimbal. The fact that it allows you to select a target to follow and a lot of other things is really, really cool. It's highly customizable. Cool thing about the gimbal is that it actually allows you to control the native cameras on your smartphone, so you can pretty much use any app you'd like. But it also has face tracking. It performs really, really good. But still to this day, when switching over to my Pixel 6 Pro, I don't have 4K 60 native in the app. I have to switch over to the native camera application, which is a bummer. And of course, in the Android version of the app, there's not a slow motion mode, which is another bummer. Makes you switch out of the app and do that stuff. Going back to iOS, that's a more robust version of the FeiyuOne app, which is cool, but at the same time, it's 2022. We're about to get to 2023 and we're still having that disparity. I don't know how to fix it, but I thought I'd let you know. Now, as mentioned before, the app is feature packed. There are a lot of really cool modes like time-lapse or motion time-lapse where you can select up to 6 different points in order to create that really cool time-lapse. And I discovered while testing this that you can actually interact with your focus point, point A to point B, as you're using pretty much every mode, like the motion time-lapse mode. So it's kind of cool to be able to switch from your foreground object to your background object as the phone was panning. There's a light trail mode, there's a dedicated dolly zoom mode that I highly encourage you to check out. And now, all things considered, I gotta kind of give kudos to FeiyuTech for sticking to the simple approach in this case, because one of the things and one of the pieces of feedback that I've gotten from other creators or maybe just families in general, moms and dads that just want to record smoother video, or real estate agents and business owners that want to kind of like dabble into the video creation side of things. They have shared with me that while the newer versions of gimbals, like the OM5, those are fantastic gimbals with a myriad different options and settings and app features and all that good stuff, it can get a little bit complex. And I do love the fact that this is a pretty straightforward OG looking smartphone gimbal. If you don't have a DJI Osmo Mobile 2, if you don't have a DJI Osmo Mobile 3, or any of the OG-esque 2-3 year old gimbals, the FeiyuTech Vimble 3 is actually a really good gimbal with higher payload capacity than those gimbals, with the extension rod at $119, sometimes $109. Whatever shortcomings the software of the gimbal has, the price and the ability to use pretty much whichever app you want, like your native camera app and extend and just freehand everything and customize these little A and B buttons as well as the dial and the second trigger in the back of the gimbal, those things kind of make up for some of the software shortcomings, in my opinion. If you're starting on the gimbal world and you just want something to stabilize shaky video, maybe you're gonna be using your native camera app and you're not gonna tinker a lot with anything else other than just recording your videos, this is a fantastic gimbal solution for $119, sometimes $109. I totally recommend it. But I wanna know what you think. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section down below. If you have any questions or suggestions, drop them down there so we can continue to create relevant content for you. If you enjoyed the video, consider liking and subscribing down below. And as always, thank you so much for sharing your time with me. It's good to be back. I'll catch you on the next one.